This is the KDLT Sports Gridiron Preview Show.
And welcome to our KDLT Gridiron Preview Show. I'm Mark Ovenden, he's Zach Borg, and believe it or not, high school football starts this Friday night.
We'll spend the next half hour previewing both high school and college teams in the region, and the first college games are in a week from Thursday. It's coming up fast, but first, here's a fast look back at 2018.
They think they're ready, and we know we are. They think they got this one. Let's go. Hey, we're going to show them who we are today.
Yeah. Bearing it up. Oh, wide open. Andrew Coverdale.
Going to run. Weaves inside traffic. Stays on his feet. Down the sideline. He goes.
Well, the guy you just saw, Roosevelt alum Taryn Christian, left South Dakota State holding virtually every passing record in the program's history. He also leaves a hole on a team ranked third in the FCS that expects to do the one thing that's eluded them, win a national title. As Taryn Christian rewrote the South Dakota State record book last year, he had a shadow.
He was actually my mentor. I actually lived with him in the summer when I got here, so I would always go to him asking questions, especially when we had home games. Anytime the offense got off the field, I would ask him, like, what did you see on this play? What about this read? What about that?
And after redshirting, freshman Jabore Gibbs is poised to become Christian's successor, in part because of the poise he exhibits.
I mean, he's real even keel. I guess the term would be he's a cool guy, he's a cool player. He does have the athletic ability like Taryn. I don't think he's quite as fast. He's got a good arm.
Though it's Gibbs' job now, he will have plenty of competition for it during the season. Mitchell alum Cannon Nelson is the traditional pocket passer, and another redshirt freshman, Matt Connors, has also been opening eyes since spring ball.
We have a really good quarterback group. We got a lot of good playmakers in there. Everybody has a different thing that they can bring to the game, which is very valuable.
Here we go.
We don't need a guy necessarily to make every play like Taryn could, but a guy to manage, to get us in the right play, hand it off to the right guy, throw it to the right guy. So not as big a playmaker, just a guy that gets it done.
And what should make that easier is the strength in numbers around their quarterback. What the three lack in experience, a deep group of backs and receivers, led by All-Americans Kay Johnson and Pierre Strong, and an offensive line which returns all but two starters, should be able to help them make a smooth transition.
I don't have so much pressure on myself because we do have so many outstanding, you know, offensive players on our team. So just get the balls to them and they'll make me look good.
It just, you got to get settled down. The game moving fast for him right now. I feel how you feel because I was in them shoes once. But once the game slowed down to him, Lord knows what he can do.
And it all starts a week from Thursday at Minnesota, almost 10 years to the date of them losing by three at TCF Bank Stadium. Look at those three games in the middle right there, too. Three of the best teams in the Valley have to come to Brookings. Schedule's favorable. It all ends at the end of the season at USD.
Now, the USD Coyotes are excited to get the football season started, and one of the big reasons why is the guy who leads them on defense. Meet Darin Greenfield, the leader of the pack for Bob Nielsen's Coyotes. Since the day that Darin Greenfield's grandfather introduced him to the game of football,
I don't ever want to be the guy that's like stuck up, won't talk to anybody. I want to be the guy that's out here having fun, because you come out to practice and you have just a crappy mentality. You're trying to get through the day instead of getting better in that day, taking every rep like you're trying to get better.
He's always wanted more.
You get one opportunity per game, one, two, three opportunities per game. You seize every opportunity you get. And then as soon as coaches see that, they'll start to take notice.
That's how the Sheldon native came to Vermilion in 2015, just hoping he could find a bit of playing time.
A couple years in, become a role player, become somebody who could be a special teams player or something like that. That was always my goal.
And turned into one of the nation's best defensive players. The two-time All-American enters his senior year on the Buck Buchanan watch list for the best defensive player in the country. Nine sacks away from breaking Tyler Starr's USD career record.
Well, I think it's really hard work, and I give him the credit. A guy that just refuses, and it's kind of the way he plays. You know, he refuses to say no, and he's made himself a really good college football player, and not only that, he's really become a leader on our defense.
And it's no surprise that the accolades aren't that important to Darin.
I want the next thing. I want, like, the year before I had 8 sacks. I wanted 10, 12 last year. I didn't quite get it. So that's left me with like a sour taste. I felt like I left some stuff on the field, and that's one thing I'm going in this season. I don't want to leave anything on the field. I don't want to leave any doubt.
Since he's always been driven to never be satisfied. All right, so here's a look at some of the key games. They start with Montana, and that is not a typo. The second game of the season is at Oklahoma. Haven't they had the Heisman Trophy winner in the last couple of years at quarterback? Yikes. Northern Iowa at North Dakota State, and of course, we just talked about that. They play South Dakota State on their home turf. The University of Sioux Falls might just have themselves a Harlan Hill Award winner. Gabe Watson finished 5th last year when he gained almost 2,000 yards and made all sorts of All-American teams. But the Cougars have always had their most success when they can run and throw, which they did last year, keeping the other teams off balance. That is going to be the plan again this year to improve upon their 7-4 record.
Going into last year, you know, we thought Gabe had a chance to be pretty good, but he was outstanding. And now, obviously, he's not going to sneak up on anybody, and our offense is still going to go through him. But we need to be able to diversify, and we've worked hard on that and thinking that, you know, we got to replace 2 tackles, 2 really, really good tackles, a draft pick and an all-conference guy. So we got to be able to get those things in, but we're going to see a balanced offense out of USF.
Now, Augustana also finished 7-4 last year, and quarterback Kyle Sadler was a big reason why they looked great at times, throwing for 3,400 yards and 30 touchdowns, twice tossing for 5 scores in a game. Coach O is counting on that kind of performance again in 2019.
Anytime you have a 2-year starter coming back, you know, this will be Kyle's 3rd year, and his numbers are really good last year. He led the league in passing and did some really good things. I think the thing he improved on the most is his leadership. You know, he's really become a great leader of the team, and offensively he knows it inside and out. So, yeah, it's a blessing to have that no controversy. Our starting quarterback is in place, and we need to make sure that we surround him with the tools that I think we have to be successful.
Lots of exciting news with all the new facilities being built in Aberdeen, but the Northern Wolves are more concerned with improving on last year's 4-7 record. They will rely on Hunter Troutman at quarterback to make the offense go. He's got 2 very talented receivers in Dakota Larson and Jacob Street. They combined for over 1,500 yards receiving last year and 13 touchdowns last fall.
This year is year 10 for Corey Sauter at SMSU, and he won't have his record-setting quarterback Blake Gimble, but he will have third-team All-American Daniel Davis back. Davis caught 79 balls for 1,100 yards and 9 scores for the Mustangs, who will look to improve upon last year's 4-7 record. One thing is for sure, they are always fun to watch under Sauter, who was Peyton Manning's backup in the NFL.
Next up, we're going to take a look at the NAIA teams in our area and really high hopes for the Northwestern Red Raiders, who returned a ton of talent to a team that was ranked 5th at the end of the regular season.